IMA Economics first year. I went there on that day, on 22nd, I went there only in the afternoon. I couldn't go before that. When I went there, they were not allowing us inside the gate. Actually, many people, protesters, were already inside. We were asking to get inside, but the police people, they didn't let us inside. And there were even some girls who were like, who were telling them that we have brought some food for them. We want to know, they are there, our friends are inside, starving, they don't have food, they don't have water, we just want to give the food, provide food to them, just let us inside. And somehow we, all of us, got inside. And when I went there, what I saw was that protesters, they were sitting behind the disease lots, in the lawns, and they were shouting slogans, police people were there. As someone already mentioned, they were also taking food from us, biscuits, water bottles and everything. And I saw some videos in which people are saying like the protesters carried weapons. All the only weapon we had was empty water bottles. If that counts as a weapon, that was the only thing we had. And I also got slapped on my face by a lady police officer. So, but the humiliating thing was not that brutality by the police, but when we were, police were snatching us away, we could see the so-called like-minded faculty inside the VC slots. They were peeping through the windows, watching us being snatched by the police. Their own students, the police were snatching us away, pulling us like anything, and these like-minded faculty, they were watching it, the show. It was really humiliating. We were, the police people were around us everywhere, but the most humiliating part was this. All of us, it was really humiliating. And the other thing, after they pulled us away out of the visas lots, and after that, these people, police were, they were pelting stones on the students, and that was something, I think, it, at least to me, it seemed somewhat strange. Police pelting stones on students, and they made us run till SSP. I don't get what is the point in that. We were already outside the VC slots, and what will we do from SSP building? Will we throw stones or something from there to the VC? I don't get the point. It is our campus, right? On that day, what thing? The first thing that struck me was like, it is not at all our university. It was like it was a police academy or something. They were removing us from their own place. It not at all felt like it was our university or something like that. And the other thing, all these days, like last few days, I was seeing when we go through the Facebook walls and everything, I see many videos in which common students, neutral students, they argue that it was the protesters who were pelting stones on the policemen. And in one video, I saw one guy, he was saying almost 50 to 100 stones were pelted on the police people. And the same guy, he was asking, like last day Akshita, she told that our professor got punched 5 times on his face. So the same guy was asking, did she count the number of punches he got? And the same guy was saying, you people throw 50 to 100 stones on the policeman. Did he count that? 50 to 100? I don't get the point. So this is somewhat, this is also humiliating. We, our own classmates are there, 25 people, they are there in the jail. Two faculty, they are there in the jail. And these people are asking, like, we are concerned about our classes, we are concerned about our academics, as if we are not. We also came here to study. We are also concerned about our academics, but we are also human beings, right? We can't keep silent. We can't keep quiet when all these things are going on. So what I want to say is that we won't back off. At any point, we won't back off. We will fight till the end, till justice is delivered to each and everyone. That's it. Jai Bhim, that's it. Thank you.